Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher, and in this tutorial we will learn about how to use section to organize slides in Microsoft PowerPoint. So let's get started, and here we have a presentation with a lot of slides. So here you can see the thumbnail view, and if I scroll down then you can see that we have total 60 slides, and I have divided the 60 slides into three different sections. Like the first section, we have the outline view, then we have animation with morph transition, and then we have animation without the morph transition, the third section, this one. So what are the benefits of using section in PowerPoint? That is what we are going to learn in this tutorial. The first thing that I would like to tell you, that if you are looking into the thumbnail view for those number of slides, then you can hold down the control key and then use the mouse scroll to zoom in and zoom out. That way you can have more or lesser slides inside the thumbnail view. So as I am using the mouse scroll to zoom in and zoom out, so the maximum thumbnail size that you can have in a thumbnail view is up to this size, and if I zoom out then the smallest size is this one. So it totally depends on the screen size and the resolution you have on your monitor. The another way to see your presentation when you have a lot of slides is to use the slide sorter view. You can also click on this button here, or you can also move to view section, and here you can choose either the slide sorter or the normal view. So in slide sorter view, you can also use the mouse scroll to have the larger or smaller thumbnails. So as you can see that the slide sorter view is a bit better than the thumbnail view, because if you have a lot of slides then you can have more number of slides in slide sorter than the thumbnail view. Along with that, you can also see the timings of the slides at the bottom and the slide number, and either the slide is having any transition or not. And you can also see the status of a hidden slide. If you hide a slide by right clicking on it, then you can also see a line over the slide number which shows that this slide is hidden. So which view is better, thumbnail view or the slide sorter view? So let me clarify you a few things, then after that you can decide that for yourself, that which view you should use when working with a lot of slides, and you also need to create section to manage slides. There is a problem with the slide sorter view, that if you select a section by clicking on the section name, and then if you right click on a slide, then you only see commands corresponding to the section only. Whereas if you are looking the slides in a normal view, and if you select a section through the thumbnail view instead of slide sorter, and now if you right click on a slide, then you see the corresponding commands according to the slide. So you might have seen the difference. Like, let me show you again that if in slide sorter I select the entire section and then right click on a slide, then you still only see the commands corresponding to the section only. Whereas in the thumbnail view, if you select a section and if you right click on a section, then you see the commands corresponding to the section, and if you right click on a slide, then you see the commands that you can apply over the slides, like copying the slides or duplicating the slides, deleting the slides or changing the background or hiding or unhiding the slides. And that is what the use of sections are. So let me tell you that how you can create new section and what are the benefits of creating section. So first I will remove all these three sections, and you can collapse or expand the section by clicking on this arrow. So I will collapse all the three sections, and now it shows you that all the sections have 20 slides each. And now if I want to, let's say, delete a section, then I can just right click on the section and can then choose remove section. So that way the section will get removed. But if I expand this one, the second section, and scroll through the slides, then you can see that all the slides of section 3 are still there, because we just remove the section, and you don't need to collapse or expand the view before deleting a section. Like if you want to delete the second section, then you can just right click it and then choose remove section. And you can see that all these slides are still available, only the section name has been removed. So I will remove this one as well and will create a new section from the beginning. So let's say to the first 20 slides, I want to create a section and name it outline view. So you can easily do that by right clicking and then choose add section, or you can also do that from the home tab by clicking the section drop down button and then choose add section. So now you can see that it has selected all the slides of this presentation. So let's say I name them outline view. And now I move down, and after the 20 number slide, I again create a section here, right click, add section, and I name it animation with morph transition. And the third one will be after 40th number slide, right here, and that one I will name animation without morph. So the section will help you to easily organize the slides. So let's say if I want to move this section down, then I can just drag and drop it, or you can either do that by right clicking on the section name and then choose move section up or move section down. If you want to remove a section and all of its corresponding slides, then you can right click on that section name and then choose remove section and slides. That way the section and the slides will both get deleted. As you can see that we only now have 40 slides, and the third section and 20 slides of that section has been removed. So the best part of creating and using section is that when you select a section from the thumbnail or slide sorter view, then it selects all the slides of that particular section. Like I have selected 20 slides just with a single click. And now I can, let's say if I want to change the background of all these 20 slides, then what I can do, I can right click on the slides and can then choose format background. And now if I apply a background color, then it will get applied to this particular section. As you can see, let me show you once again. Now I will apply a different color here, gradient color, and you can see that it has applied that gradient color to the 20 slides just in a second. Moreover, if you want to copy this section and all its corresponding slides, so after selecting the section, if you click the copy button here, or you can also right click on a slide and then choose copy, then move to the location where you want to have that new section and then click the paste button. So after the 40th slide, you have a new section with the same name, and then you can right click and choose rename section, and here I will name it without morph. Furthermore, after selecting a section, you can also change the transitions all at once. Like I don't want to apply any transition to these 20 slides, so I click on the none. I can also change the duration of all these slides at once by applying the timing, let's say 0.02 seconds, and hit the enter key. Furthermore, let's say I don't want to show these two first sections during the slideshow, so I can easily select this section here and can go to slideshow tab and then can click hide slide. And again I select this section and then click on hide slide. So you can see that in just few clicks I have made 40 slides hidden in this slide. Now if I see the slideshow, then it will start from the third section, the first slide of the third section. So you can work with this section in the thumbnail view and in the slide sorter view. The only problem that I told you before, that in the slide sorter view you don't get the commands in the context menu when you right click on a slide. So you have to use the commands from the ribbon tabs, like if you want to unhide all these slides. So after selecting the section in the slide sorter view, you can use the hide unhide command from the slideshow tab. Or if you want to change the background, then you can go to the design tab and here you can click on format background and then choose a color that you want. Or if you want to cut, copy or paste the slides, then you can also go to the Home tab and then click on Copy. Move to the end of the presentation right here. And you can also rename the section here. So if we look carefully, then this section helps you to select all the slides in just a single click which are available in that particular section. So let's say if you want to hide 40 slides, then you don't need to select the first slide and then hold down the shift key and then scroll down and then click on the 40th number slide. Instead, you can easily select 20 slides like just clicking on the section name. And after selecting the slides, you can apply all the commands which are available in the context menu, right click context menu. Like you can cut, copy, paste, you can change the layout of the slides, all the 20 slides of this section. If I click on this comparison layout, then it will get applied to all the 20 slides, as you can see here. So that way the sections not only help you to organize your slides, but it also help you to apply a command on all the slides of a section at once. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos.